Providers hesitant to require staff vaccinations due to worker shortages, and a drug maker says their antibody shot cuts COVID-19 infection risk by 66% after exposure. This and more next.
You're watching LTC News with Dane Henning.
Welcome to CNA TV Long-Term Care News. I'm Dane Henning. Today is Wednesday, August 11th, 2021. To stay in the know of long-term care news, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you are a CNA, consider becoming a NACA member for only $25, a promotion that is running until mid-September. You can enroll quickly on our website at NACACNA.org. Join today and stand up for what you deserve. Ongoing staffing struggles in the long-term care industry are preventing some providers from making the COVID-19 vaccine a condition of employment for their staff. In Maine, for example, a new industry survey found that 60% of respondents want to implement a vaccine mandate for staff, but staffing shortages amid the rise of a highly transmittable Delta variant is steering them away from doing so. So far, about 71% of nursing home staff in the state have been fully vaccinated, which is much higher than the national rate at 59%. One administrator told a news organization a state or federal requirement is likely needed. Otherwise, this facility could lose experienced staffers if the policy is pushed by only the company. Quote, I wish I knew what it would take to get folks to get vaccinated, he told local media. In other COVID-19 mandate news, Massachusetts is now requiring nursing home staff and contract employees to receive COVID-19 vaccinations. Republican Governor Charlie Baker announced the requirement on Wednesday. The measure applies to all of the state's 378 facilities and two soldiers' homes. The policy requires employees to get their first shots by September 1st, with full vaccination to be completed by October 10th. The Department of Public Health will enforce the mandate as an order in provider-operated skilled nursing homes. Exemptions will be offered to those with medical restrictions or sincerely held religious beliefs that prevent vaccination. Regeneron's Regen COV antibody cocktail delivered by injection reduces the relative risk of infection by 66% after exposure to a close contact infected with the SARS-CoV-2 virus, the drug maker reports. For those who become infected, the illness is shorter and milder after receiving the antibody shot as a preventative therapy, the company said. The new data was released days after the FDA revised its emergency use authorization for Regen COV. The cocktail now can be used after exposure to the SARS-CoV-2 virus to prevent illness in people at high risk of poor outcomes. Previously, it was authorized for use in high-risk, unhospitalized people who were already ill. Study participants were enrolled within 96 hours of exposure to a household contact with SARS-CoV-2 infection. Half received a total dose of 1,200 milligrams of Regen COV, and half received a placebo, each administered by injection. None of the participants were already infected, and none were immune to the disease based on testing. Symptomatic infection developed in 11 of 753 participants in the Regen COV group, compared with 59 infections in the 752 participant placebo group. A relative risk reduction of 81%, the researchers reported in the New England Journal of Medicine. When both symptomatic and asymptomatic infections were taken into account, the relative risk reduction was 66%. This has been your long-term care news update. Everyone have a wonderful week, and I'll see you on Wednesday.